Hey guys, welcome to Car Guy 1999 Reviews as well as Quirk Auto Dealers. Today we have the 2021 Subaru Legacy XT Touring. The XT is the turbocharged version of the Legacy. This one's finished in crystal white pearl over brown leather, which is a killer spec. 37,699. Sorry about that. 37,696 total as tested price. Look at this brown leather. It is absolutely gorgeous. Uses a 2.4 liter turbocharged boxer engine, CVT, 8-speed with manual mode. Thing is a little rocket ship of a sedan. Definitely one of my favorite sedans I've driven out there, especially under 40 grand. Just the amount of available torque that there is pretty insane. Oh my goodness. Wow. Wait a minute, did you see what I saw? I saw a hood vent. I want to know where that comes from. I saw a hood vent and there's no vent on the hood. Aha! So it gets sucked in through here. Goes in through here into the intercooler. That's pretty cool. So a nice big intakes right there. Well, not intakes, but straight to the intercooler. And then these are some of the most comfortable seats I've sat in. Have leg extension on the driver's side, not on the passenger side, but the driver's side is very welcome. First Subaru I've driven today with sliding visors. Nice. Overall, this thing is absolutely gorgeous. You have drive, manual mode. We'll be doing it driving in normal drive because with the CVT, there's no actual gears. So it's not really a point to manual mode for sporty driving. It's more for engine braking. Wow. This is absolutely insane. It does take a quick second for it to spool up, but once it does, man, this thing hauls. I wouldn't say it's as fast as the Stinger GT. It's definitely faster than the GT line, but it feels similar, honestly, just how quick it really is and how much torque is there. Man, it is insane. It's just such an amazing machine. And the fact that they could put all this power through a CVT, that's pretty impressive too, because a lot of times these CVTs like to explode under high power. And the brakes are just as phenomenal. I did not anticipate this thing to be such a machine. You know, and I've been driving STIs all day. So, it's not like I've been driving an Impreza and the base model Forcers, and all of a sudden I hop into this. Yeah, it's going to seem very, very quick. I've been driving some pretty high-performance stuff. And yet it still feels really, really fast for the segment. Obviously, it's not like a twin-turbo Lamborghini Huracan, but it is quick. It is honestly very, very impressive. As we're just cruising, if I were to mat it. So it takes a second for the CVT to get into the right gear and go about things, but I'm gonna try it in manual mode. I mean, why not? I got one last pull, so I'm gonna keep it in gear and see if I'm gonna put it into second, floor it, and see if that helps it. We go in first gear, put it into second, not bad at all, man. This thing is pretty impressive. I am blown away. I mean, I've driven one of these before, but I haven't driven one lately. But man, oh man, is this thing a riot to drive. Proper car. And for the price, man, you cannot go wrong at all. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. I'll see you all in the next one.